Welcome to Tech Learners. In today's lecture, we will discuss pattern designing. Pattern number 2, Floyd's Triangle. In the last lecture, we had discussed the most basic pattern, pattern number 1. And in today's lecture, we will discuss Floyd's Triangle. So, let's see what is a Floyd's Triangle. So, this is a triangle which is an increasing order of the numbers. Let's say in the first row, 1, in the second row, 2, 3, third row, 4, 5, 6, second row, 7, 8, 9, 10, and the last row, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So the pattern printing is very much similar here like we have done into the previous lecture. We need to identify three things. One, look for the rows, and this is a two-dimensional pattern, so we need to print the pattern using rows and columns. We need to run two loops, one for the row and one for the column. The outer loop will be for rows and the inner loop will be for the columns. So let's see how this can be done. So we need to take a variable I for printing the rows. This will behave into the outer loop. So we will be beginning from I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, I is equal to 3, I is equal to 4, and I is equal to 5. As we can see that there are 5 rows into this pattern from 1 to 5. Next is we need to run the inner loop for the columns. So we can see that there are 5 columns into our pattern. So we will run the loop for J starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the two loops. Now we need to decide that for the loop, outer loop for rows, which will be the initial value, which will be the terminating value, and how we will be updating the variable. So let's see from here. The initial value is I is equal to 1, and we are going till I is equal to 5. So initial value of I is 1 and terminating value of I will be 5. And how we are updating? From 1 to 2, from 2 to 3, from 3 to 4 and 5. So the updation will be I plus plus. Let's discuss the initial, terminating and updation values for the column. So we can see the variable J for the column is initiating or beginning from 1 and ending till 5. So this is ending till 5. So the initial value for J will be 1 and the terminating value for J will be 5. And how it is updating? From 1 to 2, from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. That is by 1. So the updation value of J will be J plus plus. Now the third thing and the important thing, what to print. We can see here 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can see a variable, integer variable, we can take and we can increment the variable, and we will be printing that separate variable. So here we cannot use either I or we cannot use J for the printing. So let's see in the program how we can print this pattern. Now let's see the program, pattern number 2, which is Floyd's Triangle. So we have taken a variable C is equal to 1. We have initialized it 1. Why we have taken? For the printing purpose. We will see it later in the program. Now we are running two loops, one for the row and the inner loop for the column. As we have discussed that the loop for row will begin from 1 and will go till 5. So similarly, and the updation condition will be I plus plus. Now the inner loop for the columns will begin from 1 and will go till less than equal to I. How is this happening? Let's go back and see into the pattern. When we printing the column values for first row, we are printing one time. For second row, we are printing two times. For third row, we are printing three times. For fourth row, we are printing fourth time. That means the terminating value for the column depends on the number of row, that is on the I. So that is why first row one time I, second row two times I, third row three times I. So that is why the terminating condition here depends on I. So we will be taking J is less than equal to I. and then updation by 1j++. Now inside the loop we need to print the value of the variable c. That is why we have said that here we will not be using either I or j for printing purpose. Instead we are taking another variable c that we have initialized by 1, and we will be printing that variable c. Remember, here we have used just system.out.print so that the line does not get changed here. We need to change the line once we are done with a complete row. So here we'll print c, and then inside we'll increment the value of the c. So this will continuously incrementing, and we'll have the value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. So that is why we have taken a separate variable c. And once we are done with one row, we will be using this system.out.println, which is used to change the line. So this is with no parameter value. This will just be used to change the line. So once we are done with first row, system.out.println will occur and we'll move to the next row printing. Once we are done with the second row, system.out.println will be executed and we'll move to the next row. So let's see, let's dry run this loop. For I is equal to 1, initially we'll enter inside the loop. Here j is 1 and j will be less than equal to 1, because in the first instance I is 1. So this loop will execute once, we'll print 1 as the value of c is 1, and then c will be incremented to 2. Now we'll occur with println, that is line changed. We'll come back to the outer loop. Now the value of I will be incremented, and now I is 2. Then we'll come into the inner loop. For the columns, here the loop will run from 1 to 2. So now this time this block will be executed 2 times. So once for c 2, then c will be incremented to 3, and this will be printed 3, and then c will be incremented to 4. Then we'll come out of this loop and line changed. So this is how our pattern is getting printed like Floyd's triangle. Let's execute this program and see the output. So this is the Floyd's triangle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and then 15. So this is how we can use the Floyd's triangle. I hope you have understood the program. For any confusions, you can contact me, you can ask me into the comment box. Tune into the channel, subscribe the channel for more such videos on pattern matching, on numbers and series. Thank you so much.